What you need is based on what you use. That is the first criterion. If you own 30 garments, and you only use 5, then what are the other 25 for? And why are they occupying time and energy in your life? This also carries over into relationships, because certain people collect relationships the same way that other people collect books, coins, plants, paintings, clothes, or whatever. What relationships are really important to you? This fundamental question requires an honest response. Next, ask yourself if owning this thought, this object, or this insight, or being in this relationship feels correct to you. Not, can I justify it because of its benefits? But, does it feel correct? This is calling upon your experience now, not simply your ideas, because many things can be justified that are not good for you and only prove to be a burden. The third criterion is to appeal to knowledge to show you what to do. This is important if the first do not yield a decisive decision. Here you are asking to be shown. Show me what I need to do. Show me what is important. Remember, you only need a certain number of objects, ideas and relationships, but they must all be very important and must have great value, because they will be sustaining you mentally and physically. So, it is not a question of denying all possessions, all relationships and all ideas, or opening yourself to everything that comes your way. Those are two extremes. Neither is a healthy path. Learning discernment and discrimination is a major part of every person's development, if it is based upon true association. I am speaking of true association. What possessions do you really use? Which ones do you really need? Why own anything else? What ideas are really helping you? Which ideas have depth and are important? Why do you need to entertain other ideas? What relationships are really essential for your development and support your spiritual growth? What are you doing in relationships that cannot do this? This sorting out creates real economy. Economy is essential because it gives you enough reserves of vitality, time, energy and motivation to direct yourself towards greater things. People who are dominated by too many ideas, too many relationships or too many possessions cannot enter a greater arena of understanding or accomplishment. They are carrying too much baggage. Their lives are full. Their concerns have overtaken them. There is nowhere for them to go. All they can do is service their possessions. They will go no further. They will be identified with their possessions, whether they're objects, ideas or people. They will be filled up 100%. You cannot add anything to them. Nothing new can enter. They are closed to life. They are, in a sense, taking care of the museum of their life. They are museum curators of their own life, keeping track of everything that has been collected so far. What a dusty and dismal existence. They look at the sky and they don't see it. After all, if your life is about preserving your personal museum, why have a universe anyway? It is just scenery. Why ask greater questions? Why feel your pain and your yearning for greater things? The man and woman of knowledge want economy because they need time to focus on knowledge and on learning greater things. They cannot be bogged down with objects, ideas or people that are not part of their greater pursuit. This is economy, and this is important. As you progress and study the greater community way of knowledge, gradually things fall away, not because they are bad, but simply because they are no longer needed. You cannot use them. You don't want to carry a lot of extra baggage. Your life, in a sense, is becoming streamlined. Your burden is getting lighter. Now you can assume greater responsibilities. As you can see from my presentation, the idea of possessions is much more inclusive than what you may have considered before. This new understanding is very important because the greater community way of knowledge represents the transformation of relationships and the entrance into a new life and a new kind of experience. You cannot make this journey if you are carrying too much baggage. You can only carry what you really need. Then you can step faster and more lightly and feel less oppressed by what you are leaving behind. When you are presented with new objects or given opportunities to buy new things, acquire new ideas, meet new people, or participate in new activities, ask yourself, what do I really need and what do I really use? What is essential? Part of this you can answer yourself. Sometimes you must appeal to knowledge, not simply to tell you the answer, because knowledge does not engage in a lot of conversation, but to demonstrate it. Particularly in very important decisions, the way to go must be demonstrated, because an idea is not enough. You must see it, know its value, and see that it is totally relevant to your life and to your needs. This comes through demonstration. People pester knowledge with all kinds of questions. Often they want to accumulate more insight, more ideas, and more people. More. But knowledge is silent. What knowledge will do is set up a learning situation that will help the person come to terms with the real issues at stake. This is because knowledge is not like a little errand boy that brings you everything you want like room service. Knowledge is the master. You are the student. Yet, people often begin their study acting like they are the master and knowledge is the student. Somewhere in the process, the entire order of authority becomes reversed, often very gradually and sometimes with very big steps. Wisdom from the Greater Community, Volume I, states that God's first purpose is to unburden you. That sounds like a nice idea. But think about what it really means. What it really means is that the whole acquisition motive must become reversed. If you are going somewhere in life, you cannot take everything with you. You can only take what you need, and this unburdens you. This gives you time, energy, mental freedom, and the ability to establish new ideas and new alliances. This redefines and redirects your entire relationship with objects and the physical world. This new relationship is not based on fantasy and past association now. It is based on usefulness and real value. This creates a healthy relationship with the physical world, with people and with ideas. Some people have wondered, why would I study the Greater Community way of knowledge? I do not really want to read books anymore. The reason is that the way of knowledge gives you a few things to deeply consider, rather than simply pumping more ideas into your mind and keeping it stimulated. Consider the idea, knowledge is with me. Where am I? You could spend many years on this one idea alone. One idea. You cannot exhaust that idea. It is revolutionary. Alone I can accomplish nothing. This is another revolutionary idea. It could change the world if it were contemplated and allowed to alter your experience of yourself and the world. Then you are no longer what you own. You are aligned with something invisible and mysterious, which is the guiding principle of all life.